afternoon, and welcome to all of our viewers on YouTube for our final live stream cabaret here on the Riverdale Children's Theater YouTube site. It's been an incredible week here, and we hope you've enjoyed all of our live streams. Today we celebrate the Orange Troupe. Please welcome the artistic director for the Riverdale Children's Theater, Mrs. Becky Lily Woods.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, friends, family, to all the people watching from all over the country and the world. We're so happy that you joined us here today for our final Summer Light Cabaret. It has been an amazing summer, our Summer Light Summer. We are frankly so joyful, so thankful, and truly amazed that we reached our final day. There were so many guidelines in place to have a camp during the pandemic. And with the help of our parents, our amazing staff, and our amazing kids, we did it all together. And I'm really, really proud of everybody. So thank you so much. But I do need to say that we could not have done this without the support and the graciousness of the College of Mount St. Vincent. This beautiful campus, these amazing spaces that were able to have the kids outside more than 80% of the day, spaces where we could have enough room for all of our kids to be safe and to be social distanced. It was an amazing gift, and we are so thankful that they were partners with us and that we were able to have this summer. So thank you. But now let's get on to our amazing Orange Troupe. We're so proud of these kids. They're singing some wonderful songs today. And let's please welcome our first performer, Morgan Avelli. Morgan is 13 years old. She's entering eighth grade, and she's done nine seasonal shows and three summer shows. And today she is singing Alyssa Green from The Prom.
To be perfect, the A's have to be straight. You have to join the debate club on that, there's no debate. You'll have Bible camp each summer to keep you pure and clean. Endless rules apply when you're Alyssa Green. Trophies have to be first place. Ribbons have to be blue. There's always some competition or hoops for jumping through. Your mom's made sacrifices, so win homecoming queen, 'cause it's do or die when you're Alyssa Green. And you wish there was a world where you were simply free to live, and when people criticized you, you had no more figs to give. And in this other lifetime, when you tell yourself be brave, you won't cave. That's one thing I truly crave. But your feelings have to be phony. Your weight has to be tracked. If you don't like shaking pom-poms, you'd better learn to act. Just have everything perfected by the time you reach 18. Don't ask how or why when you're Alyssa Green. Improve all of your strong points and hide things that you lack. 'Cause mom's convinced if you're perfect, your father might come back. Not yourself, you're not what she wants, you're someone in between. Your whole life's a lie when you're Alyssa Green.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Morgan. And now let's welcome to the stage Jaylen James. Jaylen is entering eighth grade. She was previously in Frozen, and she's had two summers at Summer Light, and today she is singing Journey to the Past from Anastasia.
Heart, don't fail me now. Courage, don't desert me. Don't turn back now that we're here. People always say life is full of choices. No one ever mentions
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Jaylin. Beautiful job, Jaylin. It's our final day of Summer Light, so today during this cabaret, I'd like to take the time to acknowledge some of the amazing people that we had with us this summer. We were so lucky to have back once again our amazing choreographer, Monique Streety. She's such a benefit, such a great energy to our program, and did amazing jobs with both of our shows. We were very lucky to have Suzanne Beaubien. Suzanne is our costume designer every year, and this year we brought her creativity to the kids through behind-the-scenes arts and crafts, where the kids actually made their own costumes, and she brought so much to it, and we were really just so happy to have her. We had a couple of teaching artists that, unless the pandemic had happened, they would not have been able to be with us. They had other things going on, very important things going on, but those things were canceled. So we were lucky to benefit from that in a way, because this summer we were able to have Emma Pittman with us. Emma was set to be on Broadway in Chicago, but with the Broadway shows closed right now, she was free. So we benefited from that in a way that we were able to have Emma here with us as our director of The Descendants, and it was just an amazing thing. So thank you, Emma, for all your hard work. And we're going to be there. We're going to be there for you to come see you in Chicago as soon as Broadway opens back up again. The other person that this was the same situation for was Guy Ventilier. Let's give him a round. He was our Shakespeare teacher. He normally would not have been available during the summer. He runs a very popular Shakespeare in the Park program and would not have been able to be with us. But this year he was free to work with our kids, and they have all learned to love Shakespeare through Guy. So thank you, Guy, and we're so happy you were with us. We have our amazing office administrator, Denise Chaloux, who's been with us many summers. We love Denise, and we couldn't do it without her. Tiffany Lutz was our program director. She was meant to be with us for a few weeks at the beginning, but she was in North Carolina and was therefore quarantined there. She wasn't allowed to come to New York, but she guided us through Zoom and she kept everything organized, and we couldn't have done this without Tiffany. So thank you, Tiffany. We can't wait to have you with us next year. We want to thank our amazing Shauna Mahoney, our director of Aristocats and also our voice teacher. Teresa Santiago, Tracy Marble, our other two amazing voice teachers. We want to thank our team, who behind the scenes was doing virtual programming for RCT while we were here. Justina Aircole ran a wonderful program this summer, along with Anna Mayo, James Marilott, and Tiffany helped them as well. So we want to say a big thank you to them. We're very lucky that Dale Smallwood was able to come in this week and help us with lights. So thank you, Dale, for being here. We want to thank our great camera crew. Thanks, guys, so much for being here with us this whole week. We couldn't have done it without you. And of course, we want to thank Derek Woods for everything that he does for RCT. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's please bring to the stage our next performer, Kyle Russell. Pardon me? Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I went out of order. Let's bring to the stage Tara Egan. Tara, you look beautiful. Tara is entering seventh grade. She has done six seasonal shows, and this is her first summer at Summer Lights. Today, she is singing Home from Wonderland. Job, Tara. And now let's welcome to the stage Kyle Russell. Kyle is entering seventh grade. He was recently in Frozen with RCT, and this is his second summer at Summer Light. And today, Kyle is singing Loser, Geek, Whatever from Be More Chill.
Like to be the loser. I should find out what it's like to not be the loser, or the geek, or the whatever. Think I felt inconsequential since middle school began. I knew I had no potential to be the leading man, but based on how today's going, I'm finally gaining ground. I even got some blood flowing with no computer screen around, which was cool. But what really felt good was doing something that I never thought that I could. It's not only school that's rough, being lonely, stupid, tough. Now I think I've had enough of being the loser, the geek, or whatever. Michael thinks that weird is rad, but feeling weird just makes me sad. And I deserve to not feel bad from being the loser, the geek, or whatever. Sick of being the loser, the geek, or whatever. Yeah. Whoa.
And now let's welcome to the stage Gia Farrington. Gia will be entering seventh grade in the fall. She's done six seasonal shows with RCT. This is her second summer at Summer Lights. And Gia will be singing I Always Knew from Annie Warbucks.
I always knew that tomorrow would come true. I always knew when it was dark, with not one star up in the sky. Hey, I still knew. I said my prayers and I would go to sleep believing. I guess the trick is that you gotta keep when you do, there go your tears, there go your dark.
ladies and gentlemen. That was Gia. At this time, friends and family, we'd like to bring out on stage the leaders of our Orange Troop, our amazing counselors. If we could please have Olivia Gonzalez and Molly Walsh come out on the stage. We'd also like to bring out Adar Marcus, who was working with some of our other troops. We didn't get a chance to acknowledge him earlier in the week. First, we want to recognize Olivia. She was our head counselor for our Orange Troop and gave them such amazing guidance and brought such a tight-knit group together with the Orange Troop. Olivia's been with RCT since she was in sixth grade. We're so happy that she comes back every summer to work at Summerlight. She's a true gift to us in every way. And this fall, she's going to be applying to musical theater conservatories, and I'm sure they're going to be battling out to get Olivia to attend their school. So thank you, Olivia. We want to acknowledge Kevin Woods, who's up on Spotlight. Kevin was working with the Orange Troop this summer. Kevin has done many RCT shows, and this summer he was set to work at another camp. That camp, unfortunately, was not able to run this summer due to the pandemic, but it was our fortune that Kevin was able to come spend the summer with us. And he's going to be heading off to Elon University in just a few short days. So thank you, Kevin, for being with us this summer. And then we have Molly Walsh and Adar Marcus. Molly worked with our Orange Troop, and Adar helped out with our Red Troop and our Purple Troop on many occasions. They were our interns last year and did such an amazing job. This year they came back as junior counselors. They're both going to be juniors next year. Adar was in our very first summer at Summer Lights and has literally grown up in our program. And Molly joined us, I think, when she was not too much older than that over at RCT Barnabas. And it's just so great to have them come to work with us in the summer. And they did amazing work. So thank you, everybody. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we would like to welcome to the stage Kelly Walsh. Kelly will be entering ninth grade in the fall. She's done six seasonal shows with RCT. This is her first summer at Summerlight. She will be singing In My Dreams from Anastasia.
Side of a road, there were tracks all around. It had recently snowed in the darkness and cold with the wind in the trees. A girl with no name and no memories but these. Rain against a window, sheets upon a bed, terrifying nurses whispering overhead. Call the child Anya, give the child a hat. I don't know a thing before that. Traveling the back roads, sleeping in the wood, taking what I needed, working when I could, keeping up my courage. Foolish as it seems, at night all alone in my dreams. In my dreams, shadows call. There's a light at the end of a hall. Then my dreams fade away. But I know it all will come back. To know who you are, to have lived in the shadows and traveled this far. I've seen flashes of fire, heard the echo of screams, but I still have this faith in the truth of my dreams.
Wonderful. Now let's bring to the stage Mackenzie Avelli. Mackenzie is 10 years old. She'll be entering fifth grade in the fall. She's done two seasonal shows with RCT today, and she's done two summers at Summer Lights. Today she is singing the classic Babyface. And now, friends and family, let's please welcome to the stage Rosabella Procario. Rosabella will be entering ninth grade in the fall. This is her ninth show with RCT and her first summer at Summer Lights. Today, she is singing One Perfect Moment from Bring It On, the musical.
Above and beyond and pull through this. asking is one perfect moment in time. I'm 17, there are so many things that I can't control. If I start to freak or feel weak, I focus on just
job, Rosabella. Ladies and gentlemen, I did want to bring one more of our counselors out, our head team counselor, Caitlin Panianqua. Caitlin was the head of our team counselors who helped us stay on track with everything all summer and worked with many of the troops. She's been with RCT since, we think she was in seventh grade, is that right? Seventh grade, as a tech volunteer at Bronx House, and then she grew to be irreplaceable for myself and Derek with everything that she has to support us. So we were so thankful as well that Caitlin was one of those special people who otherwise would not have been able to be with us this summer because she had a previous job, but she was able to spend her summer with RCT. Caitlin is just a recent graduate of John Jay College and is going to be pursuing grad school in the future. Thank you, Caitlin. Once more, we'd like to thank our amazing camera crew, Dan, Chris, and John, and Curlew, who's not here today. Thanks, guys, for being here for us. We couldn't have done this without you, and the work is absolutely stunning, so thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to say thank you once more to our families for believing in us, to let us take care of your kids during this time. It's been a crazy summer, and we are really, really thankful that you chose to have your kids spend summer light with RCT. We also want to thank you for your support throughout the past 5 and 6 months. Many people contributed their tuitions for canceled shows, contributed already purchased tickets to RCT. Many families here at Summerlight, over half of them, gave money for tickets that they would have spent money on if we'd had live in-person shows. And that means so much to us in our hopes that we'll be able to survive this pandemic and get to live shows soon, hopefully in the spring. So thank you. Thank you. And thank you to our kids. We do love you so much, and we all shared a really special summer together. So thanks for being a part of it. And now we'd like to bring to the stage our final performer from the Orange Troop, Joshua Soto. Joshua is entering eighth grade in the fall. He's been in 3 shows with RCT, and this is his first summer at Summerlight. He's going to be singing Goodbye from Catch Me If You Can.
My happy ending. Now it's time to say goodnight. We can stop pretending. Tell the spotlight man, turn off my light, 'cause the show is done now. and it's time to leave the stage. Yeah, the good guy won now, and the band has no more songs to play. It's a happy ending, so I'll say goodbye. Goodbye to all the make-believe. Goodbye. There's no more magic up my sleeve. There's nothing left to act up here. I'll take my bow and disappear. No questions left for answering. There's only one word left to sing goodbye. It's a happy ending to the greatest show on earth. Now the curtain's descending, and I hope you got your money's worth. Stop the show now, 'cause I wanna leave on top. So get up and go now, 'cause there's nothing left inside my head. Everything that's left to say has been said. Goodbye. Goodbye to all the song and dance. Goodbye. Off stage I stand a better chance. The show's been through, the part's been played. No standing in the wings afraid. No violins or phony tears. The word that's music to my ears is goodbye. A goodbye. 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 I'm not afraid of stopping. This end could be my start. I wanna live a life and not just play a part. I'll walk into the sunset. I'll sail across the sea. The final word, the last you'll hear of me. Of me. It's goodbye. Goodbye to every night alone. Goodbye. Goodbye to lives that I don't know. I'm tired of living on this stage. A life that's only on the page. The empty lives are in the past. Tried before, but here's the last goodbye.
So proud of you.
Let's hear it again for all of our cabaret singers and their counselors. And thank you so much for everyone who tuned into our live stream today and every day. Don't forget to check out the Riverdale Children's Theater as they celebrate 10 years this year at www.riverdalechildrenstheater.org. And don't forget to like us on Facebook, love us in real life, and support live theater whenever it gets back. See you soon, everybody.